Hello everybody, this is Reid and welcome to a modern video here on ChannelFireball.com. Today's deck is a little bit of a throwback. This is Modern Abzan. It's based off of or similar to the deck that I used to make the top 8 of Pro Tour Rivals of Ixalan earlier in the year. That event, Pro Tour Rivals of Ixalan, was before the unbanning of Bloodbraid Elf, so nobody really felt, you know, chained to the Jund color combination. Mostly people were liking the black and green cards, and I just liked the idea of touching into white for Lingering Souls to give you an advantage in fair matchups like the Mirror, and also Stony Silence. Even back then, Stony Silence was one of the most powerful sideboard cards available in Modern, and it's even better now because KrarkClan Ironworks is a top deck. If you have a lot of respect for the Ironworks deck, as I do, there's really nothing to be done except sideboard Stony Silence. This is the card that, it shuts their combo dead in its tracks, but it also cuts their mana by stopping the Darksteel Citadels and the Mox Opals, and it prevents them from digging to their answer cards by disallowing them from sacrificing Terrarion, Chromatic Star, Chromatic Sphere. So Stony Silence just absolutely the best sideboard card for a fair deck in Modern right now, and I think it's my working theory, at least, is that it's a strong enough draw towards playing white that it's possible Abzan could be better than Jund again. A lot of people have been not too impressed with Bloodbraid Elf. Modern's a really, really fast format, so paying 4 mana, even though Bloodbraid Elf is really powerful, 4 mana for an uncontrollable random kind of effect is just not always what you want. This Abzan deck is a little bit lower to the ground, more centered on black and green mana, and I have Grim Flayer and some extra, you know, 1-mana plays just to sort of keep pace and make sure you can present a good clock when you play against variety of different strategies in Modern. So this is the deck I have in front of me. I'm going to run it through League, and I hope you enjoy the video. All right, here I am for match number 1, fortunate enough to win the die roll. And perfect, this is just the kind of hand you hope to see. I have turn 1 discard, turn 2 threat, I even have a fatal push if I'm playing against an aggro deck, so just about a perfect hand. Okay, my opponent also keeps 7, and let's see what we're up against. This is a pretty tough matchup for black-green midrange. I've played this deck before, and a lot of the cards just give me a real headache, like this Eternal Scourge. Cast it from exile, and they can repeatedly exile it with their own Relic of Progenitus, stuff like that. Looks like my opponent's hand is a little bit speculative. Maybe they kept on the back of a turn 1 chalice. Let's consider the options here. Well, I don't think I'm going to take one of the creatures. Obviously not taking Reality Smasher, and then Eternal Scourge and Matter Reshaper are both, you know, they're comparable. Doesn't really make a lot of sense to take one and not the other. So that leaves me with the option of, I could try to mana screw my opponent, take the Spirit Guide. That doesn't really make a lot of sense since it's a one-shot mana. You know, if it was like a Mox Opal or, you know, whatever, say it was a Mox Jet, then I could see taking it, but for just a one-shot mana that's going to give my opponent card disadvantage and potentially leave them stuck with only one land, that's okay, I'll let them have it. So really I'm deciding between Chalice of the Void and Dismember. The Chalice doesn't really do that much against my hand. It's going to shut off the Fatal Push 1-for-1, but doesn't stop my creatures My deck's not that vulnerable to Chalice, plus I do have two Abrupt Decays and two Maelstrom Pulses that I could find. So I think I'll take Dismember and just hope that Dark Confidant and Tarmogoyf can run away with things. Okay, so that's my opponent drew for the turn. It was Zulfir and Void. They get a Scry, potentially looking for more lands. And we'll see if my opponent decides to go with the turn one Chalice or just be patient, wait for next turn. Goes for the Spirit Guide Chalice. That is fine by me. And now I still think Dark Confidant is the best one to get into play. Even though there's some temptation for Grim Flayer. I mentioned this being kind of a challenging matchup. Chalice of the Void is not one of the cards that's particularly good against Black-Green. My mana costs are just spread enough, and I can kill the Chalice, so I'm not too worried about it. All right, well, let's get in for two and play. Well, actually, what to play is a fair question, because if I just play Grim Flayer and my opponent plays one of the three drops, I might not be able to attack through it. But maybe the upside of hitting once with Grim Flayer is enough. So I could trade Grim Flayer and then make a big Scavenging Ooze. Fatal Push puts a third creature type in the graveyard. A third card type. Still, I think probably just Tarmogoyf is better because I know I'll be able to attack through whatever my opponent plays. I don't really want to plan for the scenario where my opponent misses their land drop because it's so easy for me to win that game anyway. I want to plan for the bad case scenario where Matter Reshaper hits the board. Just another Chalice, not threatening at all. So I can even just cast this Spellbomb to get another card type and pump my Goyf, get closer to Grim Flayer. That, by the way, is exactly Niall Spellbomb's job, is to get extra card type in the graveyard for Goyf and Flayer. Alright, so I'm just going to come in, I'm going to play the Fatal Push into the Chalice, which will get me Delirium. I think it's still worth it. Alright, well, those are all really good. Put the swamp on top for the so the Confidant doesn't deal me any damage. All right. So far, so good. Now, after sideboarding, I guess these are the cards that I'm considering. It's really hard to know. It's hard to sideboard for this matchup because the games can play out in such widely different ways. I am worried about Relic of Progenitus, and a lot of times this deck has other artifacts, like they could have Ratchet Bomb or Mind Stone or Serum Vision or Serum Powder. So I could see bringing in some number of Stony Silences smaller than four, like maybe two. In which case I would not want Nile Spell Bombs. I would say the Paths and probably the Damnation, those are in for beating Reality Smasher. Fulminator Mage is good. Either take out a temple or a value land. I want some number of discard spells, but not all six. Then the Liliana seems okay, but not great. But I can't just like everything. The Liliana of the Veil on the draw is a little unreliable. I don't know, it's very unscientific sideboarding, but I want to have access to a variety of cards because the games can play out in a lot of different ways and they go long. I want to have answers to everything. I'm going to try this, and it's definitely not perfect, and maybe I'll have a little bit of a better idea what to do for game number three. I don't know about this Lingering Souls either. Especially when I'm expecting my opponent to have relics. Well, I'll definitely have to mulligan this one. Guess this is okay against certain kinds of hands my opponent could have, but not my favorite. Sure. So at least something that's something that I can fatal push. So it's ascribed to the top. Opponent's actually going to get to mana screw me by naming a fetch land with Sorcerer Spyglass. And it's the fetch land that I have exactly one copy of. Which is, I guess it's better than the alternative, but it's kind of ironic. Ah, but my opponent does not do that. I wonder if maybe they didn't know. Like, maybe they thought it was more similar to Phyrexian Revoker. But I'm pretty happy that I now get to use my fetch land. Plus, the Fulminator Mage might just be good as a 2-2. You know, get some beatdown. Alright, so a fetch land will allow me to Fatal Push the Thought Not Seer. Looks like I'm not going to be able to make that play this turn, but actually Thought Seize will pump my Goyf big enough that it can beat the Seer in combat, so let's see what we're up against. I mean, I certainly... well... taking the Serum Powder would give me a 5-6 Tarmogoyf, but the other two cards are just way too important here. I think I should take the Reality Smasher, because if my opponent dismembers the Goyf, then at least I can Fatal Push the Thought Knot Seer. So I think that'll be the plan. Whereas I can't beat the Smasher unless I get the Goyf up to a 5-6. So goodbye Reality Smasher. And I think I just passed the turn because I'm behind on life total. What's this going to be with Eldrazi mana? Another Thought Not Seer. Well, surely my opponent will take one of the Fatal Pushes. Still not an emergency situation, but this could get a little dicey. Well, that could be good a couple turns from now. For now, all I can do is pass the turn. Remember, my opponent has Dismember, but if the Goyf gets dismembered, I get to kill a Thought Not Seer. So we're in an interesting little holding pattern right now. Sure. Sure. So here's Fatal Push with Revolt. All right, this would be a good time to draw a land. Oh, you're kidding me. Two cards that I can't cast. All right, so now I'm going to fall down to 5, and I can still come back, but a lot of things can go wrong now. Scavenger Grounds, it's a nice one. Gotta hang in there till I can cast Damnation. I think I should block the Mimic. I mean, it's annoying that it turns off fetch lands, but I don't think chump blocking is the way I'm going to win. Nope. Well, I feel like I didn't learn that much about how to sideboard from that game. My opponent did not play any relics or ratchet bombs or anything like that, so... Oh, wait, did I just not... I thought I had brought in two Stony Silences for that game, but I was going to take one out for game three anyway. Let's just have one. And then... Three discard spells felt about right. Maybe third Liliana of the Veil when I'm on the play. And actually, Liliana Last Hope doesn't feel that bad if my opponent's going to have Eldrazi Mimic, but maybe still just one is good compromise. And then two Lingering Souls might be enough. Or maybe Grim Flayer is bad, since it's not larger than a lot of the creatures. I'm taking out my artifacts, and my opponent could have Graveyard Hate anyway, so bring back the souls. I kind of like two souls, maybe one more Inquisition. Again, I do not have a high degree of confidence, but I feel like I can't be going too wrong if I submit this, and that's what I'm going to do. Hand is kind of slow and bad, but I think I'm going to keep it. At least I have my mana, and this is the kind of matchup where there's not really one card that you're mulliganing to really want in your opening hand. It's just... You just want to have your resources... Yep, that's a good start. Hope I draw a castable card this turn. So that's a Scry to the top and a Matter Reshaper. So that makes Liliana of the Veil pretty bad. And this is going to be tricky because normally my best play next turn would be Fulminator Mage, blow up Eldrazi Temple, but then I'm taking 5 damage and not really progressing the board. So I don't know if I can afford to do that. Alright, I probably need to do it that way, just Fulminator, and then next turn I can go Thoughtseize Lingering Souls. I'll be at 9. Yeah, it's bad. But I don't think I am winning if a Thought Knotseer or Reality Smasher comes down this turn. I guess having seen the Spyglass, it's a little more reason to not have a lot of copies of the same Planeswalker. Maybe I should have stuck with just two. Maelstrom Pulse, a decent draw, but for sure I'm going to start with Thoughtseize. Okay, well, I feel glad that I killed the Eldrazi Temple. Spatial Contortion, Reshaper, Smasher, Smasher. So I'm going to take either the Reshaper or the Contortion. I think I should take the Reshaper. I'm still pretty far behind in this game, but I'm not in an emergency situation yet. So I can double block, protect my life total, and force my opponent to use the contortion. That's probably worth it. So trade two spirits for a contortion and 3 points of life. No, my opponent decides to just trade. Find Surgical Extraction. Not a card that I would normally be scared of, but it's actually pretty good here against Lingering Souls. Full Mirror Mage is an excellent draw. Remember, I know my opponent's hand has Reality Smasher, Spatial Contortion. So I think my play here is to cast the Fulminator and pass so my opponent can't attack me with the Mimic, and then plan to kill the Blink Moth Nexus. So if I find a land, I can Maelstrom Pulse the Spyglass and then start using Liliana. Mutavault makes that tougher. Okay. So this is going to make my Goyf a 5-6, which means it can't even be double-teamed by Mutavault or Mimic plus Spatial Contortion. And then if the Goyf can hold the ground, then I can play Liliana and start ticking up to knock those Smashers out of my opponent's hand. It's at least a plan. There's still a lot that can go wrong from here. Well, I just have to block. I mean, I don't think there's any way I'm... Yeah. Okay. That is definitely something. Now I can get the Liliana down and answer both of my opponent's creatures. So this is just great for me, keeping my opponent low on mana, protecting my planeswalker. This was a really fortunate draw. So that's a really fortunate draw also. Well, a game that was looking really bad. I had, I guess, three strong draw steps in a row and found myself now in a really dominant position. Well, that's not a very good play. That's going to make you take more damage. Okay, so my opponent just decides that enough is enough. And wow, yeah, a few minutes ago I thought I was dead for sure, but I do win that match. I'll be 1-0 going into round two. Hello, welcome back for match number two. On the play with a strong hand, although one where I'm going to have to take a lot of damage. Hope I'm not playing against Burn. Humans. Pretty tough matchup, but one that's fun to play. Wow, and that's a really, that's a punishing hand. I guess I gotta take the Thalia's Lieutenant. Yes. I'm probably gonna lose this game. I guess Tarmogoyf for starters. I guess the plan is stabilize the board first, then try to get a little advantage off Dark Confidant. Maybe find a Maelstrom Pulse, that would be sweet. Ask and ye shall receive. Alright, Dark Confidant and pass, and hopefully the Glyph can hold off these creatures for one more turn. There are a lot of ways this can go wrong, like a Thalia's Lieutenant or a Reflector Mage. Looks like a Reflector Mage. So, feels like I should block the littler one, although, I mean, with the Maelstrom Pulse, maybe I'm supposed to get greedy here. I think I'm going to get greedy. It did not work out. So now I just pass with the intent to block one and Abrupt Decay one. All right, I'll let it in. I think my opponent should name Fatal Push. I mean, maybe they'll be a master and overthink the situation that I would cast the Fatal Push in response to the Meddling Mage, so maybe you name the second best instant speed removal. I don't know. That's an interesting situation, a lot to think about. Maybe it was a little bit too risky for me to do it that way. Well, I can't even, like, I'm just dead on board even if I hit Maelstrom Pulse, so I have to block and Abrupt Decay the bigger one. I think I would have been in the game if I found an untapped land last turn, but I think there's just no way at this point. Nope, dead on board. It's wild how punishing that humans deck is. You mean you miss one thing and they just don't give you any breathing room. So the path's coming in, Damnation, probably Liliana Last Hope. And then out comes Nile Spellbomb, Thoughtseize. Then I'm on the play where the Lilianas and the Confidants are at their best. So maybe I want to cut like a Grim Flayer, but when I'm on the draw, I probably want to go down to three Confidant, three Liliana of the Veil. That's a pretty bad hand. I think I should mulligan. That's better. I guess it probably doesn't matter whether I scry top or bottom because I'm very likely to crack a fetch land on turn one. I actually think I should just fetch because I want to find action. Shambling Vent is very slightly better than Blooming Marsh. See exactly what my opponent decides to do before I decide about how I'm going to spend my fatal pushes. Sure, so I think I want to get the freebooter. Well, I mean, I could actually just kill the big champion and not care about the freebooter, because I'll get my fatal push back if I ever cast Damnation. So I kind of like this a little better. I guess I'll wait on casting the Grim Flayer until after Damnation. Sure, no blocks. Yep, that's fine. So, fine cashing in the Damnation for a 2-for-1. First of all, my opponent knows about it. Second of all, I can't really play a creature until I use the Damnation, so not perfect, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Lots of freebooters. So this turn will be Fatal Push the Freebooter and Path the Mantis Rider. But I really need my opponent to not find Militia Bugler. I mean, I guess at a certain point, Grim Flayer will come down as a 4-4 that can block it. But just my opponent finding more action would be pretty bad. So I guess this is a fine spot to get greedy. I'm going to attack with the Flayer. My opponent will block. I'll Abrupt Decay and Trample over. The reason I do it this way rather than just Abrupt Decay and attack is this way it's a little harder for me to get ambushed. So interesting, if I kill the Staticaster, then my Grim Flayer dies. But if I kill the Reflector Mage, then I can't play Confidant. I think I'm fine just not playing Confidant for a little while. Well, I mean, I could send the Shambling Vent. It's really bad if my opponent has a card to ambush me. I guess I'll probably just play the Inquisition. Doesn't really do anything. Sure. I have a lot of good draws from this position, like even a fetch land turns on the Fatal Push and lets me get my Confidant to play. Removal spell is good, a beefier creature is good, a Planeswalker is good. Alright, I guess I'll take it. meddling mage named Path to Exile, which I actually don't even have anymore, so it's tricky. Do I Fatal Push or do I wait and see if I can kill the Static Caster? I think I just gotta kill the Lieutenant. Yuck. So I could send with the Shambling Vent, just trade with the Meddling Mage. I don't think I like that very much. Having a lot of trouble getting Delirium. Grimflayer, this was my 60th card that I left in. I cut one of my two. It's really not performing that well. That's also bad against the Staticaster. Maybe I made my deck too weak against the Staticaster. Also, maybe I should just play one of the Confidants to get Delirium. Yeah, I probably should have done that two turns ago. No, the Militia Bugler! Now I'm in trouble. Thalia's Lieutenant. All right. Hopefully it's not too late. I eat a creature. In the upkeep, just to play around either a second Staticaster or a Phantasmal Image. Sure. I mean, I could take it or put the Flare in front of the Lieutenant. I'll do that. No, more buglers. Another champion to perish. Not the worst thing that could have happened. Boy, this Staticaster is just giving me such a headache. I wish I could find a Abrupt Decay or a Maelstrom Pulse for it, something like that. So this is the turn that I really need to fade. Really need my opponent to not have Reflector Mage. I mean, even just on the board, I can easily lose this because you can see how quickly my opponent is amassing power and toughness. But dodging Reflector Mage or like Mantis Rider would be really important this turn. If my opponent has to suicide a creature in to kill Liliana, then that's okay for me. That's probably what I need to start getting back in the game. This has been a kind of a crazy game. I thought I was going to win for sure, and then I thought I was going to lose for sure, and now still feel like I'm going to lose, but it's a little closer. Wonder if I can actually start attacking. Okay, I think I can start attacking. Because I get one hit and then my opponent has to chump block the next time. Wow, what a game. So I had mentioned that Liliana of the Veil and Dark Confidant both get a little weaker on the draw, so maybe I want only three of each of those. And I'll bring a Grim Flayer, and oh man, I'm not excited about Thoughtseize. Maybe I just need another card for this matchup in my sideboard somewhere. I mean, it's definitely not these, definitely not Choke, definitely not Stony Silence. So I have to choose from these kind of mediocre cards over here. I'm on the draw. All right, one Thoughtseize. I guess it is good, just good to have a cheap card when you're on the draw. I think I probably want to top that. Just one Dark Confidant and all removal spells. That's about the best you can ask for. A strong hand. Particularly annoying that two of the lands are Horizon Canopies, so my opponent is not going to be flooding anytime soon. I guess I take the Thalia. Yeah, that's, I think that's just about the perfect human's hand. Three lands with two canopies, turn one Vile, Lieutenant, and two disruptive creatures. See if my opponent names the right card, which would be Fatal Push in this case. Yep, good name, good name. Yuck. So I'm going to be taking a minimum of 7 damage here. I guess I have to path the meddling mage and fatal push the champion and just hope my opponent hasn't found much else. Start by sacking the canopy, I like that. Wow, do I actually live to fight another day? And is this, do I take my spot to maybe untap with Liliana? Think if my opponent had a 3-drop human, it would be in play already. Plus I need to take some chances if I'm going to win this game. This would just be an absolute miracle if I'm able to come back. Sure. Well, it's going to be dicey. Good draw, good draw. So I'm going to lose the Dark Confidant. I'm not that interested in him when I'm at 5 life. And wow, my opponent discarded Hostage Taker. I can't believe I actually got a great card out of my opponent's hand with the Liliana. Yep. So all 3 coming at me. I'm going to double block this freebooter. Nice one. So I think I just cash in the Liliana. No need to get greedy here. And play around exactly Mantis Rider, which I'm not that likely to beat anyway. Feel like the 1 damage could matter. I mean, yeah, I'd probably lose if my opponent draws Mantis Rider anyway, so I think I just don't want to miss the 1 damage. This time I'll leave the spirit back because I think that 1 turn of breathing room means that I actually have some kind of hope of winning if my opponent draws a haste creature. I guess I'll just eat something now to play around Kessig Malcontents. Pretty specific, and I don't think my opponent has it, but I'm definitely going to be using the ooze anyway, so why pretend? All right, take four. Flashback the souls. And I think I'm starting to turn the corner here. Wow, what an awesome match. I was at death's door in all three of the games and managed to come back in two of them. So 2-0, and I'll see you for round number three. Hello, I'm back for match number three. And a nice hand. Can definitely work with this. I'm going to go for Godless Shrine Inquisition. That means no Confidant on turn two, but... Well, it means no Confidant on turn two with the cards that I have, but I could get lucky and draw a land, or if not, I can just play a second Inquisition and tap the Treetop Village. So I like that line a lot better than playing the Treetop Village on turn one. My opponent has Mulligan to six and Scry to the bottom. Okay, looks like I'm up against Hardened Scales or some kind of artifact creature deck. Interesting. I mean, I could take Steel Overseer. That's the obvious move, but then I'm somewhat likely to miss on my Inquisition next turn. So I'm almost tempted to take the Worker and then take the Steel Overseer next turn. It's kind of weird to be taking an Arcbound Worker that's not particularly threatening, but I think it's actually right. I can make any future Liliana of the Veils a little stronger. So now I've committed myself to casting Inquisition. Even though I did get lucky, it's not the time to play Confidant. I think I'm more scared of the Hangerback Walker than the Overseer, which I can just decay. Yeah. So now I've sort of tempoed myself back to the Stone Age here, because I'm not going to be able to play my Dark Confidant until turn four, since I've now committed myself to abrupt decaying the Steel Overseer. Although, I don't have to decay because my opponent doesn't have another creature, but man, it's pretty bad for me if they find another Hangerback Walker in the meantime. Maybe I go Lingering Souls and then Confidant Decay. It's a little greedy, but I want to make sure I have a board presence by the time Karn comes down also. It's been a tricky game. I mean, my hand is great. And my hand is great, and I've played one spell per turn. And even with that, I've had so many different decisions, so many borderline decisions that you could make a case for one way or the other. Now I'm going to kill the Ballista just because I'm pretty desperate to get my Dark Confidant into play. I think it would have been reasonable to kill the Overseer and Flashback Lingering Souls. But just one more turn with a lot of close decisions, and this is the one I picked. Don't know for sure that it's the best one. Really need my opponent to not have a Ballista here. You can have a Mox Opal, that's a Hardened Scales exiled with a silver counter. Okay. It's not as bad as a Ballista, but it's probably the next worst thing. Just jump with a Spirit. Well, Maelstrom Pulse is great. I can just kill Karn directly. A lot of options here. Definitely, I will be Fatal Pushing Steel Overseer. Yeah, I think just Fatal Push Overseer and Maelstrom Pulse Karn puts me in pretty reasonable position. Oh, I'm in my upkeep right now. That was silly. All right, Stirrings could still find Ballista and be really strong. Another Karn. Yeah, there's Ballista. Throne of Geth. Well, this works out well for me because I can now knock the Ballista out of my opponent's hand with Liliana. Although now the hanger back can get sacrificed. Sure, I'm fine with this. It's a close game. I'm guessing my opponent will sacrifice the hanger back walker at the end of the turn. And then could potentially kill the Liliana or could potentially just go after my life total, given the two confidants. Going to be very close. All right, looks like my opponent is going to try to set up one more turn before sacrificing the hanger back. Oh no, another hanger back. Jeez. Well, I guess I gotta block both. Yeah, I'm just dead now. Maybe I should have taken five, see another card. I can't even Maelstrom Pulse the Thopters because the Throne of Geth can sacrifice one in response. So I think I'm just dead. Damn, this felt like a game that I should have been able to find a way to win, but definitely an impressive showing from the Hardened Scales deck. Given that I drew my... I'm still thinking back to the early turns of the game, dwelling on it. Given that I drew my second land untapped, I think I would have been... Well, I for sure would have been in better shape if I had just taken this Steel Overseer with my first Inquisition, and then I could have played Confidant on turn two. It worked out particularly badly because my opponent drew another powerful card that I needed to take away with the Inquisition. So it was, just kind of a big tempo problem for me. All right. Either way, I lose that game. I do have four Stony Silences in my sideboard, so we'll see how much that can improve the matchup for me. Path to Exile and Damnation also seem strong. What else is weak here? Don't want all my Liliana of the Veils. Yeah, I guess in general, I don't want an excessive number of Lilianas. Sure, I'll try this. Well, turn two Stony Silence. Functional hand with turn two Stony Silence. You're not mulliganing that. I like to get the Liliana in play anytime there's a safe opportunity to do so. Particularly safe because even Walking Ballista can't kill it under the Stony Silence. So let's plus. I'll lose a Tarmogoyf if I'm fine with that. And then Goyf Confidant. Well, my opponent made a really good play there, holding the Darksteel Citadel to discard to Liliana, just knowing that it's not going to do anything in the face of Stony Silence. That's fine. Well, I think I just play out everything. Start with Inquisition. Probably take the Ancient Stirrings. I don't love the idea of pathing when my opponent has Karn in hand. But the alternative is just not using Liliana. I think I would rather path and plus. So my opponent left with a Karn and a Ballista. Now for game three on the draw, I think I want another Inquisition. And Liliana of the Veil is kind of looking worse and worse. Maybe I want zero. Zero Lilianas. But the other options are kind of bad too. Yeah, all right, one more Thoughtseize. This is definitely not as exciting as my Well, either of my first two hands were, but I think this is a keep. Turn one Inquisition, reasonable mix of lands and spells. Damnation is probably one of my stronger cards. I'll give it a try. It's not going to be an easy game because I don't have either white mana or Stony Silence, so it's pretty hard for me to be casting my best card in the matchup early. But maybe I can just win the old-fashioned way. It's a strong hand. So you have Blink Moth, Darksteel, Opal, Ballista, and I have to take Hangar Backwalker. There's my white mana, good start. If I just play the Tarmogoyf, my opponent can make the Ballista into a 4-4, but even that would just be trading. Darksteel Citadel, one unknown in hand. Maybe I go Temple Garden Goyf, and then I have access to the path next turn. Maybe I just path. Do a draw step path. Ancient Stirrings finds Hangar Backwalker. That's definitely one of the more annoying cards in the matchup. Yep. So now I think, man, I could just pulse it right away and then have Damnation coming soon. The otherwise, I'm going to put my Goyf into play. We're going to have a standoff where my opponent gets two counters every turn, and then eventually I'm going to have to Damnation away my own Goyf. So I definitely do not like this situation, but I'm going to Maelstrom Pulse the Hangar Backwalker before it gets out of control. canopies. That's fine. This is pretty ugly. Damnation has not been very good so far in this league. Just having to use it for sort of like one-for-one situations. Certainly not what I would hope for. I mean, you can see how good the Hangerback Walker is. I spent 2 cards and 7 mana to answer it. That's just pretty outrageous. Now, that construct looks kind of unassuming, but it's very likely to be like a 7-7 next turn between Karn activation, play something from hand, activate all the creature lands. So my Tarmogoyf doesn't even match up that well against the Construct token, which is why I went with Lingering Souls to try to put a little bit of pressure on Karn, but even that's tough because Blink Moth and Ink Moth together make a pretty good defense. Yeah, Hangerback Walker and Karn are the trouble cards in this matchup. You can definitely have Darksteel Citadel. That was a Walking Ballista exiled with a silver counter. So yeah, these constructs can be 8/8 on the board. So what do? I block one with everything. So 7/7 and counting. So now I send some treetop villages at Karn. Still in very rough shape. So good patience for my opponent to not dismember during combat last turn. I know that was a big temptation, but here my opponent knows that if they can defend the Karn, they can minus to get that walking ballista, which is going to be lethal at my low life total. So, I mean, I was definitely not going to beat the dismember, you know, regardless, but... Props on the tight play here. So ballista for three, kill the spirit, attack with construct, and that'll do the trick. Impressive showing from the hardened scales deck. I don't think it's like a terrible matchup, but certainly the Karn and the Hangerback Walker make it really, really tough. You usually can't answer those cards on a one-for-one basis. All right, so 2-1 with Abzan. I'll be back for round number 4. Hello, everyone. Currently 2-1 with Modern Abzan. This is round 4, and I have a pretty medium hand on the draw here. It's good against an aggro deck like Burn or, you know, even passable against humans. But... I think I could do a little better. It's pretty close. Maybe with a treetop village in the mix I would keep, but I'm going to throw this back. Well, this one I grudgingly have to keep. Hope to scry a land at the top. Well, Scalding Tarn for Steam Vents and Serum Vision, that's actually a pretty common opening in Modern. Could still be a lot of decks, but Storm is going to be my first guess. Which, that's okay. Storm is a pretty decent matchup for Abzan, although I would say I'm not off to a great start in this game because I might miss my land drops. I think just getting Swamp is fine here. Could be playing against Blue Moon or something, so getting the basic is has a little bit of value. But looks like it is Storm after all. So we have two creatures. I have an Abrupt Decay. And Liliana, Maelstrom Pulse. So I guess maybe if I'm going to hope to hit a land drop, then I should just take the Serum Vision. But it's either that or take one of the creatures and try to Abrupt Decay the other. But I think I like taking the Serum Vision, reduce my opponent's ability to dig and hit the land drops, and then if I actually can get Liliana into play, then I have a realistic route to victory. Alright, so let's perfect hit my land drop. Let's start by taking out that Electromancer. Now if my opponent has to just play the Barral into Liliana, that's really good for me. Okay, well, if I can only play one spell this turn, I still think it should be Liliana. Hey, Alex. Plus and discard Maelstrom Pulse. Not terribly worried about empty the Warrens in this current game state. So that's an opt to the top. The fact that my opponent didn't respond with the opt is a little bit telling. I mean, either my opponent made a little bit of an error, or I can deduce that they don't have remand in their main deck. So I know about a Barral, a Desperate Ritual, and a card that was scryed to the top with opt, and then a fresh draw step. So let's see what my opponent can muster this turn. A lot of action. Okay. All right, so I think I just go -2 and then play another Liliana of the Veil to knock the last card out of my opponent's hand. And part of the reason I want to do this is I'm racing to get to the ultimate on Liliana. So just putting an extra 2 loyalty on this Liliana is comparable to getting Liliana last hope into play in terms of clocking my opponent. Kind of funny that I haven't drawn any creatures yet. I'm not complaining, my draw's been good once I hit those land drops, but I can't really use the -2 of Liliana to any great effect here. Finding something like a Scavenging Ooze would be pretty sweet. Alright, well, I think it's just Fatal Push plus plus. All right. Now I want to ultimate. I think my position is strong enough that I should be able to leverage this into a win. And I think I'm just happy splitting Ascension against one Steam Vents. Ascension and one land against the other lands. All right. There are a lot of ways that could have gone wrong from my opening hand, but I was able to get that nice Inquisition into Liliana play that's so effective against Storm. Now going to sideboard, Path to Exile, I don't think I like it. I want to kill those creatures, but not at the cost of giving my opponent an extra land. Choke and Fulminator, again, not exciting, but they do something. But these three cards are the one, I mean, I guess these two, the Damping Sphere and the Nile Spellbomb, are the cards that I'm excited about. And then these five are the, you know, sort of marginal, at least they do something type of cards. So definitely keeping Maelstrom Pulse because it can kill a creature and empty the Warrens or a Pyromancer Ascension. And having seen Ascension in game one, I'm going to keep my Abrupt Decays also. Probably don't need all of this removal given that, but maybe like at least two Fatal Pushes. Liliana Last Hope is kind of poor. Lingering Souls is my worst of my threats. So I think the Cage and the Choke are in. Especially if I'm bringing in the Cage, the Souls get a lot worse. So let's swap those for the Fulminators. Maybe three Push and two Fulminator and see how this serves me. This one's a mulligan. If I had a discard spell, I could consider it, but I'll throw this back. A Grudging Keep. Scry that to the top. Okay, so Serum Vision, one top, one bottom. I think I'll just start with Treetop Village. Now, priority is Fatal Pushing that Electromancer. Then might as well spend my other mana on the Nile Spellbomb. It's a nice little insurance policy. Hope I draw Liliana. Okay, well, Inquisition, I'll definitely take it. So we have Bar All, Gifts, Past, and Flames. So that's pretty bad for me because it means my opponent can resolve Gifts Ungiven next turn. I guess I should take Bar All. Yeah. At least the Nile Spellbomb is good for counteracting Past and Flames. I'm sure my opponent will Gifts this turn. Probably just a value Gifts. Might find, I don't know, another Gifts and pieces of the puzzle. Just general value cards to play a little bit of a longer game. That's a nice draw. Still not much to do besides just attack and play another creature. And then I'll let my opponent make their decision about the gifts before I Fatal Push the Electromancer. So just to recap, I need to know about a Pyromancer Ascension and a Past in Flames. Alright, opponent deep in the tank here. So really, I just want to, well, I've done a nice job assembling a reasonable clock here, so I want to reduce my opponent's ability to set up over the course of two or three turns here. I actually think I don't care about Blood Moon because I can just win with the Tarmogoyfs. I'm going to Fatal Push the Electromancer. But the nice thing about putting Blood Moon in the graveyard is it puts an enchantment. So what to do? I don't think I want my opponent to have repeal. Maybe I give the Blood Moon and the Gifts because those are the clunkiest cards. And then I push the Electromancer. And my opponent's going to have to spend next turn doing what? Casting Blood Moon? Blood Moon's actually kind of bad for me. Alright, how about Blood Moon and Repeal to the graveyard? So Pyromancer Ascension, Past in Flames, Manamorphose, which might get cast in response here, and Gifts. Now my opponent lets it go. So one play that I could always make if I want to is to Nihil Spellbound myself, which would put a fifth card type, allow me to attack for 13. With a fetch land, it would be 15. Alright, so take 8, and then I'll play Scavenging Ooze. And put my opponent to the test. Combo off this turn without using the graveyard, that's the challenge. Probably put any mana creatures into the graveyard. I feel like that's how it has to start for my opponent, is getting Baral or Electromancer out. Okay, so if I give Manamorphose an empty, then that already is empty for 6. So maybe I have to actually give both creatures. My opponent's hand, Pyromancer Ascension, Past in Flames, Manamorphose, one unknown. They'll get their fresh draw step. I mean, if I'm going to give one creature, I have to give both creatures. And it might be pretty bad for me if I give the Manamorphose empty. It's pretty bad because I'm not worried about dying to the empty, but my opponent can, already has just three cards that would produce six blockers by a ton of time and not even put them down on cards because the Metamorphosis cantrip. So I think I can't give my opponent the empty, so I should give both creatures. All right, it's a little dicey. I'm kind of worried about what's going to happen to me this turn, but we shall see. There's Barl. My opponent is dead on the board if I activate the Treetop Village. Even with one blocker. Grape Shot, the Ooze for three. Sure, I guess I'll just gain one life in response. Oh, oops. Correction. A few turns ago, I had mentioned that I could Spellbomb myself to get an extra card type in the graveyard. That actually doesn't work because Spellbomb will hit the graveyard immediately and then exile itself. So that's a play that is not on the table. But looks like just firing up the Treetop will force my opponent to chump block. They will go to two life. And then we'll see what they can put together. They do have the Electromancer. Yeah, I don't think I'm that worried about the Ascension. I mean, another Metamorphose would be good. That's fine, though. Sure. Well, this could be bad. Now I guess I gotta hunker down and probably try to sit behind a Dark Confidant. I'm not playing Jund, so I don't have Lightning Bolt to draw into. Word out those Lingering Souls, which would actually be pretty good here if I could cast one. Confidant could find me Maelstrom Pulse or even Abrupt Decay to take care of the Ascension would make me feel a lot safer. Certainly, I have to pop the spell bomb in response. I'll go ahead and draw my extra card. Need to fade a lot of cards here. Even something like a sleight of hand would likely result in me dying. Spire Bluff Canal. All right. Come on, Maelstrom Pulse, Abrupt Decay, something. Nothing. Okay, well. Time to start attacking with some stuff, I guess. Yeah, probably just the two Tarmogoyfs. Okay. Okay, I like it. I like the play. Remand just as divination here. Could even remand your own remand, but I think that's probably worse. Oh no, that's what my opponent decided to do, is just remand their own remand. So it's a remand and an unknown card. Boy, those confidants are not doing their job. All right, Gifts Ungiven is going to be big trouble. I guess I just take the opt. I'll fire up my treetop village and see if I survive another turn. Sure. So it's going to be 3 mana for gifts. Find ritual. There is still a Manamorphose left, right? Fourth Manamorphose. Found the fourth Manamorphose. Okay, so this is over. I guess as long as my opponent has another Grape Shot in their library, it is within the realm of possibility that one could have been sideboarded out. So I guess I'll just F6 and let them do their thing. All right, so I guess my opponent can empty for like 1,000. Shouldn't really matter what cards I put where. Yeah, maybe there's no Grape Shot, in which case I can be drawing to Maelstrom Pulse. It's also possible that my opponent does have Grape Shot in their library, but just didn't want to search for it with gifts as a way of playing around Surgical Extraction. I think like a really savvy, careful Storm player might take a line like that. But still, I don't see any reason for me to concede until I see the Grape Shot. Okay, empty. That's going to be, what, 42 more goblin tokens? So I get three shots at a Maelstrom Pulse, and I need my opponent to not have a second remand. Decay, one turn too late. All right, so I think I lose. That was quite a game. So my changes, based on seeing the way my opponent sideboarded, I think I definitely do want my fourth Fatal Push, and I want the Damnation against three copies of Empty the Warrens. And then I suppose Fulminator is just my worst card. I think I still have enough pressure to feel comfortable winning the game, so let's run with this. On the play in a post-sideboard game should be my my largest advantage, and I think I have a pretty good sideboard for the matchup, even packing a Damping Sphere, which I think most Jund Abzan decks probably wouldn't have. Yeah, see, this hand's perfect, just what I want. Can even fetch basic Swamp to play around Blood Moon. So we have Tarn. That's a little bit of a speculative hand. Well, I guess I could take... I'm choosing between pretty much a Braid or Manamorphos. I'm on the play, so yeah, I'm just going to take Manamorphos. Try to stick my opponent with no lands. Sure, so Opt was the draw for the turn. Scry to the top with Opt. Still know about Desperate Ritual, Empty the Warrens, Gifts Ungiven, Past in Flames. So I probably want to start thinking about getting that Scavenging Ooze into play. We'll see what I find off my Confidant and my draw step. Well, this should help inform my decision a little bit. Alright, I'm just going to take the Ritual, I guess. Not too much to worry about here. Take the Ritual, play a Goyf, play a tapped land. Damnation. All right. I am attacking for six. I'm playing Scavenging Ooze. Yes. Repeal the Goyf, I can live with that. So let's eat my Confidant and your Desperate Ritual. Eat those rituals and one of the metamorphos. Just looking to reduce the potency of past in flames. My opponent probably intending to gifts here. At least I feel very well insulated against the graveyard. I guess, is there any... No, I can play around Anger of the Gods reasonably well by abrupt decaying my own creature, so I'm not worried about a board sweeper. Just play out my stuff and not overthink it. I guess I am down to 10, so I have to worry a little bit about just getting, like, double grape shotted. I'll probably put a grape shot in the graveyard if my opponent searches for one. I still know about Empty the Warrens and Past in Flames in hand. Just send What? Metamorphose. Metamorphose and Electromancer to the graveyard. No, probably Metamorphose and Desperate Ritual. Sure. So normally here I would abrupt decay in response, but I actually don't want to add to my opponent's storm count. Gifts. Maybe now is the time for abrupt decay in response. So now my opponent's stranded with Past in Flames and Empty the Warrens in hand. If I just don't give them two rituals, I think it's probably over. Okay, pretty sweet match. I'll see you for round number five. Hello, and welcome back to the fifth and final match here with Modern Abzan. If I win this one, I'll be 4-1, which, in my opinion, is a pretty successful league. I'm on the draw with a pretty strong hand. This is going to be good against either control or aggro. So my opponent doesn't have anything too special to overwhelm me. Alright, well, normally the default play would be to play Shambling Vent on turn one, but there's a good chance my opponent's going to play a creature on turn two, in which case I might want to just curve nicely Fatal Push into Confidant into Liliana. And since I have three untapped lands, that's actually a little more realistic. And in the worst case scenario, I just wind up fetching for a tapped dual land anyway. Looks like I'm up against Grixis Death Shadow. So, turn two Death Shadow is not the most common of plays. It could happen, but more likely my opponent's going to have something like a Gurmag Angler as their first creature. I do have that somewhat covered with Maelstrom Pulse and Liliana, but still a really, really good card against me. So I think Godless Shrine is fine. I do want to get another white mana so that I can activate my Shambling Vent when I need to. So my opponent will definitely have to answer the Dark Confidant this turn, and the nightmare scenario is an answer to the Dark Confidant that costs a small amount of mana and a Stubborn Denial. I think this turn I should play Maelstrom Pulse on the Angler, and I do this just to use my mana a little more effectively in the face of a possible Stubborn Denial. Next turn I may want slash need to play a 3-mana spell and a Fatal Push if I'm going to get back in the game. Of course, that would require drawing an untapped land. So thankfully my opponent did not have Stubborn Denial at that crucial turn, so I'm still in the game. I would have been probably just tempoed out if my opponent had been holding the right card. Serum Vision was bottom top, the scry. So no flash creatures that I have to worry about for 2 mana, so I could do Liliana minus, or I could just do Fatal Push Ooze. I think I like Liliana minus. So here we want Plus and Maelstrom Pulse, and I should discard probably just Scavenging Ooze because I'm choked on green mana here. Like Fatal Push in a way is my weakest card, but since I'm gonna have to pair Fatal Push with Liliana Edict to manage my opponent's creatures, I think it's important to keep this in my hand, and it's just really mana efficient. I can always discard it next turn if my opponent doesn't play any creatures. But for now, let's get rid of the Ooze, Maelstrom Pulse that Angler, and then pass with mana open. I've been pretty fortunate to draw my removal spells that kill the Angler. A lot of times in this matchup, you know, you're lucky to kill the first Angler, and then the second one sort of gets you, but drawing both Maelstrom Pulse in addition to a Liliana is really nice. So I should definitely worry about Snapcaster Mage here. Sure. Plus one, discard the Blooming Marsh. Then play Liliana. And plus. And I'm sure my opponent will Snapcaster Bolt the smaller of the Lilianas. It's actually kind of interesting whether I want to Fatal Push the Snapcaster or not. I think I probably should. Okay, just Kolaghan's Command, returning the Angler. Yeah, that's a good play as well. I'm curious why my opponent didn't just kill the Liliana at the first opportunity. Seems like leaving it with one loyalty is a lot worse. All right, so what to do here? I feel like I'm committed to blocking the Gurmag Angler, which means that I likely want to go minus two on my Liliana of the Last Hope. Maybe I just search for forest, minus two, pick up, you know, probably the ooze, play out my hand, and then plus one. It's generally worth thinking about whether you want to fetch before an activation of a Liliana of the Last Hope. It's a good habit to get into. Gonna eat that Snapcaster right away. So my opponent discarded Snapcaster, kept one card in hand. It's got to be something powerful. Probably like a Death Shadow, because they did take Fatal Push from me with the last Thoughtseize. I will block. Wow, and my opponent decides to concede. I thought that was a relatively close game, but I guess if my opponent had kept the Fatal Push and then drawn a blank, then the Planeswalkers are sort of taking over at that point. Well, so far so good. I definitely like Nile Spellbomb in the matchup. Choke is pretty good. Liliana Last Hope is pretty good. Path to Exile is great. And then Damnation I can consider as well. And what do I not like? Well, I don't want to have too many cards that kill only Death Shadow. So, actually, Abzan is kind of stronger than Jund in the sense of having more answers to the bigger stuff. Of these five cards, I can kill the big things, and then I want to keep probably at least two push and at least one Fatal Push, probably more. Sorry, at least I want to keep both Abrupt Decay and at least one Fatal Push to answer Death Shadow. Not sure how many of these discard spells I want, probably about five. And then the creatures are all fine, with Grimflayer being the weakest. So I don't have as much to take out as I thought I might. On the draw, maybe just something like this. Let's try it. Lingering Souls is excellent in this matchup. One of the hardest cards for the Grixis Shadow deck to beat, in my opinion. This one I'll have to throw back. My opponent either missed a land drop or just accidentally skipped their turn. It's hard to know for sure which it was. All right, well, That's two times that I've just drawn the card that my opponent thoughts used away. Pretty convenient. I'll grab Godless Shrine and just cast Lingering Souls from my hand. I think at the low life total and choked on mana, my opponent's just going to get overwhelmed by these spirit tokens. Well, mana screwed opponent sees the writing on the wall, and I'm going to finish this league 4-1. So, pretty decent showing with Abzan, especially when you consider that I was very much in the match that I lost against Hardened Scales. Maybe with some tighter play or a different sideboard plan, I could have, on a different day, had a 5-0. But hope you liked the deck, hope you liked the video, and stay tuned for more modern content here on ChannelFireball.com.